Heat waves have long formed part of the Australian climate, but science clearly shows they're getting worse.
When we think of heat waves, we can consider their intensity, frequency, duration, timing, spatial extent. The list goes on from there. And almost all of those characteristics have shown some sort of increase over the last 70 or so years.
Dr. Sarah Perkins-Kirkpatrick should know. She was lead author of a landmark global study that assessed heat waves down to regional levels. The findings were stark. Almost every region experienced a significant increase in heatwave frequency since 1950.
The changes that we're detecting, especially in heatwave frequency, are due to background climate change caused by human emissions.
Extreme heat heightens the risk of bushfires, places extra pressure on transport and energy systems, and poses a serious threat to public health.
Victoria is sweltering through a heatwave with power outages in multiple Melbourne suburbs.
Authorities say Victoria's record-breaking heatwave in 2009 contributed to more than 370 deaths. Climate models reveal the trend towards worsening heatwaves will only accelerate as average temperatures warm.
You don't need a large change in average conditions to see a really large change in extremes. It's a really sensitive relationship.
And that's something that worries Dr. Perkins-Kirkpatrick, both as a scientist and as a mum of two young children.
It's concerning because I know how bad the changes are at just 1 degree warming. It doesn't take much to join the dots and say how much worse are heatwaves going to be by the end of the century.
But she retains hope that the world will make the necessary reductions to greenhouse gas emissions. Optimism she intends to pass on to her children as they get older.
It's definitely worth communicating that to them so they don't go into a fit of climate anxiety, which can be, you know, really hard for them as well.
Dr. Perkins-Kirkpatrick is recipient of the Dorothy Hill Medal, which supports the work of women researchers in the earth sciences.
Again, this is a conversation I'm having with my 3.5-year-old. She's already learnt that there's differences between boys and girls, and constantly I'm saying to her, there is none. Boys can do what girls can do. Girls can do what boys can do. Don't let anything hold you back.